Devious Monkey Tripping here. So today, I'm just gonna do a little bit of a follow-up on what I was talking about with the CBD that I got on Saturday. I got some CBD gummy worms, or gummy bears, and I had decided to try them because the first time I tried the CBD gummy worms that a friend had given me, they gave me the shits. So I started taking them first thing as soon as I got them Saturday morning. So I took them Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and today I have had the shits all day long. Fail, didn't work. I mean, they worked because I'm in so much less pain to the point that it's almost non-existent, but now I got a pain in my ass because I had the shits. Ha ha, joke's on me. All right, and I had said to myself, you know, it might actually be worth it to have the shits if, you know, it gets rid of the pain like this. Yeah, no, not worth it. That made me start researching on what it could be, because clearly there are people that are taking this stuff and, you know, they're not spending their days in the bathroom. I had to figure out what it was. So I started researching it, and I think I have come up with the culprit. Many CBD products, edible products, especially gummies, we all know gummy bears aren't the most healthy thing in the world, and they put a lot of filler stuff in it. When I actually looked at the ingredients of the ones that I got, despite this place being supposed to be, you know, this great natural supplier or whatever, using all great ingredients, dude, it's just junk. It's filled with all kinds of sugar. It's got fucking carnauba wax in it. I mean, come on, you know, I'm eating car wax. The big problem that I have read, and the reason that most people get the shits, and they usually get pretty bad diarrhea, I guess, is because of MCT oil, which is a derivative of coconut oil. So a lot of these products have coconut oil and or MCT oil. What did I find on the ingredient list besides car wax? I found coconut oil. Now, I know for sure that there are times when some of the health drinks that I make to help clean me out, I use coconut oil, and they do clean me out, or coconut water, that is. And we all know that if you're stranded on a desert island, you're not supposed to try to drink coconut water all the time because you will crap yourself to death, which I don't want. So that's it. I think I found the culprit, being that these shitty gummy bears have coconut oil in them, amongst other garbage. In my research, I found that there was indeed a lot of places that talked about having successes and failures with different brands, so on and so forth. And I guess I didn't research it enough, hence my issue today. One of the other things that I kind of want to follow up on my video yesterday and my lack of a video the day before is always turning to and churning out product. I have filmed basically this, which is today's video, probably 5 times. When I went out for the walk earlier, I filmed, hated it, deleted it, tried it again, deleted it, did it a third time, deleted it, did it a fourth time, and was like, all right, fuck this. I'm just not gonna film anymore. I'm just gonna walk. And that was that. And then I thought to myself, you know, I think I'm actually hitting a point where I'm not gonna post every day because I can't think of anything even semi-interesting enough to post. But then as I ran to the bathroom, I thought, well, I guess I can post a follow-up to the whole CBD gummy bear thing. But really, my point is, I don't want this to be a chore. I want it to be something I wanna do, but I also wanna provide some form of entertainment or information that's worthwhile instead of me just blathering on every fucking time I post a video. I don't know if I'm doing that or not. At least people are looking, they're watching. So I'm not really doing this for absolutely nothing other than my own jollies. The fact that I took the move, so I'm sort of incorporating a lot of different videos here. One, getting the craps from CBD gummy bears. Two, following up on not posting and posting and having to feel like you need to post all the time. And three, selling my Panasonic G9. I finally packed that thing up yesterday and shipped it off. And that was a huge step for me because it has literally been months that that thing has just been sitting, not doing anything. Yes, I sold it once and didn't get paid and had to take it back and all that kind of stuff. You know, but then I kept convincing myself that I wanted to keep it, that I was gonna do something with it, that the things that I didn't like about it weren't bad, but were. And just the overall slackerness of not just making incisions, sticking to it. The fact that I packed that bitch up and mailed it off yesterday, and come hell or high water, it's gone, was a huge step for me. I'm not usually indecisive like that, in that, you know, I kind of make up my mind. Sometimes I'm a little bit too quickly decisive and I jump into things that I probably shouldn't, or I spend money on something that I shouldn't. But, you know, here we are, and I've gotten myself down to the cameras that I have, which are the Sony a7 III, and my Sony a6600. I mean, I had 5 camera bodies at one time. I mean, that's just stupid. I did not need all those cameras, and I probably didn't need to buy them to figure that out. And that's what I'm not doing now going forward, is I'm not rushing into that. I sort of like got rid of stuff. It took me a while, but I got rid of the stuff that I wasn't using, therefore I did not need to keep. And hopefully now someone else will get them and do great things with them. All right, so the question portion of the video. I'm curious, for all you people that take products like CBD, how do you decide what you're going to use or not use? Do you just blindly buy something? Do you just walk into a store and try something? Did your friend suggest it to you? Did you research it for days on end and get medical studies before you decided what you were gonna try? Let me know in the comments. That is all I've got for today. Thanks for joining me, and you know, like, subscribe, all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.